Hey guys, how you doing? This is JP Saricolia coming to you once again with another episode of Age of Heroes, my podcast. So before we get into the nitty-gritty of this video, of this episode, I want to invite you, if you have not watched Avengers Endgame, I recommend you to go and watch it first before, you know, listening to this podcast. If you haven't watched the trailer of the upcoming Spider-Man Far From Home, I also recommend you to watch that first and then come to see me. There's a lot of spoilers in this episode, and I don't want to spoil anything for you. I want you to enjoy Avengers Endgame. If you haven't watched it first, then you can talk to me. If you haven't watched the trailer, I recommend you to watch it. Then we can discuss it, because we're going to talk about that trailer. And we're going to talk about the future of the MCU based on the trailer and based on Avengers Endgame. Well, now, without further ado, putting that aside first, put that warning label in the front first. Now let's get into it. Definitely, we are very excited. Particularly, I'm very excited. And I know a lot of people are excited. If you follow social media, YouTube videos, everybody and their mama are talking about that trailer, the Spider-Man Far From Home trailer. Definitely phenomenal trailer. A very fun trailer. And definitely gives a lot of hints of what the future is going to be for the MCU. And we are really excited. You know, my mind is blown to know, to think about the possibilities here. Now, if you watch the trailer, of course, you know, there's the mention of the multiverse, the mention of, you know, this is the aftermath. We all knew this was the last film in this phase of phase three of the MCU. So, you know, as most people, you know, like you, when you think about this movie, you think, of course, this is going to be the end of this. What's next? We don't know exactly what's going to happen. But I can tell you one thing. If you know comics, if you're a fan of comics, you know that all comic stories, all sagas, you know, they always have at the end of that saga, that's what we call an epilogue. And the epilogue technically is just the setting. It's just finalizing everything, all the different trends in the story, but also opening the door or the portal for the next story arc. And I'm telling you, just the trailer alone makes me feel that this is the epilogue, of course. It's not only a movie, just a, pretty much a just an end. It's an epilogue for the next phase. And you know that for sure. It just feels that because they already, there's talks about, the, of course, the multiverse, in this case, the snapping of the finger of, in this case, at the end of Iron Man, it really opens a portal or left a portal open in the universe. So there's a converging of different universe, different Earths, all in the same timeline coming all together. And definitely, it's just amazing just to see this. Of course, this is something that you know for comics. If you follow comics, of course, DC Comics, there's always that the ideas of multiverse ideas. But Marvel also has a multiverse ideas, and they've been experimenting with those multiverse ideas in more recent times, you know, in pretty much in the 2000s. Pretty much since Joe Quesada took over, there's been an experimentation with the multiverse. There's multiple universes, multiple teams, Avengers teams, X-Men, you know, you have the Ultimates, you know. Technically, you've seen this converging, many different worlds happening, and of course has given the possibilities for many different stories. People like Jonathan Hickman, Avengers, you know, you have things, different variations and versions of the X-Men. So the opportunities and the door is so open for so much stuff that definitely you can see that the possibilities are here for the future. And definitely this movie, just the trailer alone, is setting the stage, is preparing people for what is to come. Now, this idea of the multiverse is not something new. We already had the hints before through the Marvel Universe, through the different MCU movies. We have seen some of this hint. So we saw that hint when we watch, of course, Doctor Strange. Doctor Strange already hinted a lot of the ideas of the different universes, parallel universes of dimensions. We saw some of that ideas introduced through Ant-Man. And of course, it was very used. The minuscule universe that he's part of was used, of course, and at the end with the time traveling part of the Avengers Endgame. And of course, we see this timelines expanding and changing. And of course, there's a lot of, if you watch Avengers Endgame, of course, you know, when Captain America goes back in time, you know, a lot of people are speculating how is it that he goes back in time and in this case, marries Peggy Carter, when technically that would be the future. Now, the past is the past. How can he just doesn't affect the time, you know, pretty much the time spectrum, the time continuum. So a lot of people are saying, well, maybe that was a parallel universe. And even my wife, who is not really much into comics, but she loves the CW's versions of Flash and the Arrow, and she understands very well the concept of multiverse. She was telling me from the get-go, say, I think it's because this is a parallel universe, not necessarily the same universe. And, you know, this is the idea, because in reality, you know, when, you know, in this case, Captain America goes back in time to return all the different stones to the different time frames. He has to go. He has the stones. He has a time stone. He also has the reality stone. So he has to return all these artifacts. So definitely he can just go whatever he needs to go, you know, because there's no, I would say, limitations of the time traveling or where he can go through the different portal of time. So, you know, it is amazing. And of course, everybody's talking about it. If you go back, I follow, of course, Rob from Comics Comics Explain. He has a very video where he's extremely excited. He's talking about the possibilities. Love that video. Also, if you watch Comic Historian, he is talking pretty much, Comic Historian is talking about it, you know, presenting the possibilities. You know, of course, you know, everybody's talking about it. A lot of people are talking about it. A lot of people in the movies, reviewers. But if you really pay attention to the people that know comics, they're more excited than anybody else because, of course, we have followed comics. We know the stories. We know the possibilities here. Now, as you know, with the Fox deal, you know, now that, of course, Disney owns X-Men and the Fantastic Four, the movie rights again, the possibilities are there. Now, there was always a question, how are they going to introduce these characters? As I mentioned in previous episodes and previous podcasts, you know, Disney is going to figure a way to bring him in. You know, how they're going to do it, it might take a little bit of time, but they're going to bring him in. And of course, Feige mentioned before that they're not have the plans yet for the next 5 years, perhaps, but they're already setting the stage. And this movie is really proving that, because the possibilities to bring the X-Men are there, or the Fantastic Four. Now, if you think in timeline terms, you know, or the timeline that we have with the Avengers, technically everything we have seen so far in the MCU has been the Avengers. And this is definitely, the Infinity Sagas have been all about the Avengers. And we have seen their timeline, but we have not seen anything, or we haven't received any hints of what happened with the X-Men. Where are the X-Men? Where are the mutants? Or, of course, what happened with the Fantastic Four? You know, there are integral parts of the Marvel Universe, but they haven't been hinted. Of course, we knew that they couldn't do it because of movie rights. But now, but the idea was, or the question was, how are they going to introduce him now after the Avengers happen? Pretty much after the destruction of this Avengers, well, not the destruction, but now, of course, Iron Man is no longer here. Tony Stark is no longer alive. So Captain America is in a different time zone. Now, of course, now we know, you know, Thor is going with the Guardians of the Galaxy for a time, which also brings me some news that we got, that there was a signing. We got the news that, in this case, Chris Hemsworth signed a deal with Marvel for 5 more movies, including, you know, Thor 4. And including Guardians of the Galaxy 3. So there's going to be 3 more movies that he's going to be part of. So this is definitely good, because people, I love, you know, Thor. I love Chris Hemsworth, and I love what he did with Thor, Thor Ragnarok. But definitely I love the way he portrayed Thor in Avengers Endgame. You know, the fat Thor definitely was a kick. You know, it was something that I have so much fun with it. He really had fun. He has this comedic element. There was a lot of, I would say, things that were played there, but I would like to see a more fleshed out Thor as time progresses, to see that there's so many stories of Thor that can be, you know, they need to be told. And in the next movies, it will be great to see that, a development of that. But with this multiverse, also the door is open for more things in the future, perhaps with Iron Man coming back, at least some cameos, Tony Stark, but also, you know, Captain America. You know, of course, now, you know, Falcon is the Captain America. He might be the Captain America in another movie. You never know, because all of this is from the comics. You know, this is nothing new. A lot of people say, well, I didn't like that he gave the, you know, Chris Evans, oh, you know, in this case, Steve Rogers gave the you know the shield to Falcon instead of giving it to you know, in this case, the Winter Soldier, which, you know, some people kind of follow the comics. But if you know the comics, do you know that actually Sam Wilson has carried the shield far longer than the Winter Soldier Bucky Barnes ever did? You know, he was you know, back in the 80s, you know, back in, I think he was, you know, in the early 80s, he had the shield for a time. He was the Captain America, and in modern times, not only in the recent, more recent times, he's been Captain America again. You know, he's been carrying the shield for a time. So the opportunities are there. They're setting the stage for a lot of things to know what the future will bring. We don't know, but the door is open. And I think the way to explain why the mutants weren't there, of course, is through the multiverse. You know, you can have parallel universe, a universe that is all about the mutants, about the X-Men. You can have a parallel universe where it's all about the Fantastic Four. And then, of course, you can bring them all together into some type of big event. So the possibilities are there. You know, the possibilities to bring more characters into this through this different universes is a really tantalizing idea. It's a really exciting idea, an opportunity to really bring a lot of characters that they weren't part of. You know, bringing things together. You also saw that in the idea was already when we saw, what was that, Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse, which is just a, you know, pretty much a animated film, but it was a phenomenal film. And I review, and if you wanna watch that review, I have the link for you if you're watching on YouTube. But it was a great idea because he presented that idea of multiverse, you know, the Spider-Verse. There's so many different versions of Spider-Man and pretty much in the universe. There's so many different dimensions, different universes with different Spider-Mans and different variations and different styles, you know, Asian, you know, African-American, Hispanic, and all of that. There's that. And that idea is so fresh, and it's bringing those ideas to the forefront and definitely applying it to the movies. It will be a phenomenal way to really give longevity to these movies. Because one of the biggest problems I would say movies have, particularly superhero stories, is that, you know, you go through a season and then you finalize with that arc, and then you move on, and then you reboot the series again. And I don't think people will like to see this, because rebooting, you know, killing a franchise and rebooting it again, it's not always a good idea, particularly for movies. It's something that we have seen throughout the years, but it's something that has never really has left a indelible, you know, ineligible mark in our lives that would say, well, this is phenomenal. Yeah, they're great stories from DC and Marvel in the past, but the idea to have a continuous flow of stories going from one to the next, it's such an opportunity for great storytelling. Marvel has really, against all odds, has proven that it's a possibility there, because they, after 22 movies of a single universe, you know, definitely proven that there's always room for more heroes. And Marvel has an array of stories that they can tell. So many different variations of the Avengers, so many variations of the X-Men. You know, there's so much potential there. You have the villains like Galactus, which is technically not a villain, but a force of nature. But then you have also people like, you know, like Doctor Doom. You have people like Kang the Conqueror. You have so many different, the Galactic Wars, the Kree Empire. You have, of course, you know, all of this, you know, the Inhumans. You know, hopefully they make an Inhumans movie, a real good Inhumans movie, not like the Inhumans show that was a piece of garbage, but they do something great on with them because they're great characters. The possibilities are there. Of course, we know the Eternals are coming, how they're going to make it happen. So the possibilities are there, you know, to create the Galactic Wars. We want to see Kassar. You want to see, you know, Adam Warlock. You want to see all these characters, you know, fleshed out in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. And the possibilities are there. And they seem that they staggering, they put in the pieces in the right place. So this trailer gives us a lot of hints what the future is going to bring. And that makes this movie more exciting now than ever. Because before, people say, well, this is the end. Yeah, you know, it's just whatever. It's just the aftermath. We're just going to move on. It's just a simple movie. But now this movie is hinting towards a lot of things from the MCU moving forward for the next saga, for the next, you know, story arcs. And I'm definitely looking forward to it. Makes this movie more exciting. If you were not really excited, I was kind of like a little bit iffy about it. you know, I'm still gonna watch it because I love those movies, but I was not like super interested or like I was with Avengers Endgame. But now I feel more interested with this because definitely this is an epilogue to the saga, but also, you know, it sets the stage for what it's to come. Definitely we are going through exciting times. And if you don't feel excited, then, you know, I don't know how we can change that. The door is wide open. The possibilities are wide open to see the X-Men now introduced maybe through this system, you know, separated from, you know, what the Avengers have been, and also the Fantastic Four. Definitely is a very tantalizing idea. Definitely is something, the possibilities are there. The multiverse gives us that opportunity, and we are really excited. I'm very excited for it. But what is your opinion? What do you think about this? Are you really excited for it? Are you not so much? Do you think that in this case, Marvel is doing the right thing by introducing the multiverse or making things a little more murkier and more confusing for fans? I would like to hear your opinion. Please leave your comments below if you're watching in YouTube, if you're listening to the podcast through, you know, iTunes, Stitcher, Spreaker, any other services. You can actually go to my Facebook account, my Facebook page, and you can actually leave your comments there as well. So once again, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Please hit the notification button so you're reminded of the next video if you're doing this in YouTube. Follow me on the, you know, in this case on the podcast, you know, follow the podcast, subscribe to the channel, that way follow me on social media. All the links are down below, and please consider supporting me financially. Through your financial support, I'm able to keep this channel and the podcast going. You can do that through Patreon on a monthly basis, or you can do that through PayPal or GoFundMe as a one-time gift. So once again, God bless you. Take care, and I'll talk to you again. Bye-bye.